Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being here. My name is Greg Burris. I'm Springfield City Manager. I'd like to welcome you to this groundbreaking ceremony. We're very excited about this. We've waited a long time for this moment, and we're excited to kick it off. First thing I want to do is recognize some folks in the audience. So we have elected officials here. Of course, Mayor Bob Stevens, who you'll hear from in a moment. Councilman Jerry Compton and Councilman Greg Fischel are here. Thank you for being here. And Representative Charlie Miller, thank you for being here. You know, New York City is known as the Big
Apple.
Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love. Detroit is the Motor City. Chicago, the Windy City. Las Vegas is Sin City. Hershey, Pennsylvania is the sweetest place on earth. But there are some other cities that claim various nicknames. Albertville, Alabama is the fire hydrant capital of the world. Winnemucca, Nevada is the city of paved streets. We have that. Concord, New Hampshire is the city in a coma. Decatur, Alabama, the wave pool capital of the world. Leola, South Dakota is the rhubarb capital of the world, and yet Sumner, Washington is the rhubarb pie capital of the world. Bertram, Texas is the home of the Oatmeal Festival, and Dothan, Alabama is the condom capital. Loup City, Nebraska is the Polish capital of Nebraska, and DeKalb, Illinois is the barbed wire capital of the world. Germont, West Virginia, the gymnastics capital of West Virginia. I think we can do better. The Queen City of the Ozarks is, in fact, the birthplace of Route 66, and that's what we're here to celebrate, because there can only be one birthplace of Route 66. The plan was created through an extensive public engagement process and approved by City Council in August of 2012, and I would like to publicly recognize Ralph Rognstad, Vern Morgan, and Mike McPherson, specifically out of the city team, because they really took ownership of this project, reached out to the community, and got a lot of civic engagement to get us to where we are today. Springfield's ties to the College Street corridor date back. Yeah. Springfield's ties to the College Street corridor date back to the 1830s, when Springfield forefather William Fulbright settled with his family near a large spring located in what is now behind me, West Meadows area of Jordan Valley. The spring served as a water source for the nearby homesteads, but it also served local congregations who used it for baptisms. When we began talking with neighbors and others in the College Street corridor, it became obvious that Springfield's lack of recognition of our own status as the birthplace of Route 66 was a missed opportunity. Today we celebrate the groundbreaking of what will be, I'm sure, the first of many phases of revitalization of this entire route 66 to our city. And with that, I would like to introduce our Director of Planning and Development. Please welcome Ralph Rognstad.
Well, it's very great to see such a big turnout. I think it really reflects the emphasis that we have on Route 66. Mike, very much started on this process back in 2011. Started looking at what some of the issues were in the area, and then in 2012 we started having public meetings. And it was really surprising. We didn't really have Route 66 on our radar screen when we started it. West Meadow. We need to do more about West Meadow. We need to have a clean clean up. Hope to have a trail in there for the next year or so. One of the issues, of course, that we ran into with the park was because of the banners, we needed to come up with some type of funding. And one of the ideas we had was to do crowdsourcing. And that's been the, we do one project, Red's Giant Hamburg Sign, which is shown here. We were able to raise $15,000 through crowdsourcing. I know a lot of you here actually helped we've also put some money together to actually do the initial phase one design and construction of the park, and that's of course what we're here for in the groundbreaking. In August, when we have the ribbon cutting and the Route 66 festival, we will have the driveway in for the park, and there'll be parking, and we'll have the red sign in. And then we're going to continue with our community funding opportunities to try to begin to build a lot of the other elements of the park. We have a card you can get, we'll be handing those out, that actually has a little bit of the, sort of the conceptual design of the park, and then the other elements that we want to be included in the park, and that we're trying to raise money. We've set up a fund with the Community Foundation where we can continue to take donations. So we see we've begun to make progress on the plan, and we think that over the years we'll see much more progress. We're also working on actually extending the plan. Our neighborhood group is going to begin a planning effort this fall, going from Kansas over to scenic Kansas, or Chestnut area. So we'll have another stretch of the route that we hope to be able to support more of Route 66. Ultimately, we'd like to also look at the area from National to Bloodstone along St. Louis. And that 4 mile stretch from Bloodstone all the way to scenic will be the area of main emphasis for the Route 66 project. We are going to try to incorporate different things along other parts of the route, but that'll be our main emphasis. One of the things I like to do with the crowdfunding for the, the initial support of the crowdfunding and other activities is recognize a few people. One, of course, is Brothers Brewing. They've been very supportive. Jeff Schrag will speak here shortly. The West Neighborhood Alliance has been a big contributor to the effort. Rusty Worley's the president of that. Guy Mace, also Councilman Craig Fisher. Hy-Vee did the initial fundraising. We have Luke Rogers here from Hy-Vee. The Chevelle Club made a nice donation, as well as Clarence McElroy. And we couldn't have really been successful with the effort if we hadn't had a lot of support from Crowded. Crowded waived all of their fees, and they put a lot of support behind us on how do we promote the whole effort. So I think that without that support, we wouldn't have gotten as far as we did. Also, I'd like to recognize that Tommy and Glenn Pike. Tommy's the president of Route 66 Missouri, Route 66 Association. He's here. And the association has been also very supportive of the work we've been doing. And actually, prior to this, they had been bugging us for years that we needed to do more. And, now we're trying to do that. And finally, I'd like to mention that Mike McPherson continues to try to work on supporting the effort. He is now putting on a open mic night at the Billiards Blue Room the last Wednesday of each month, and the first one will be next month on the 27th from 7 to 9. They're going to be trying to raise donations there as part of the music event. So if you we have cards for that as well if you'd like to pick one up. And it's good to see that he's continued to support that, and we hope that that'll help continue to bring more of the community involvement into the process. Of course, Billiards is on Route 66 on the other end, so that's a good venue to be using. So again, I really appreciate everybody showing up, and I hope that we'll have a park here soon for everybody to enjoy. Thank you, Ralph.
Now that the speaker's on, we're going to start over. Hi, my name's Greg Burris. I'm the city manager of Springfield. There's only one city that is the birthplace of Route 66, and that city only has one mayor. Would you please welcome the Honorable Bob Stevens?
Judging by my emails, I think there are several other mayors out there. But I'm delighted to be here this afternoon or this morning. I want to give a shout out to my colleagues on council, Jerry Compton and Craig Fischel. Thanks for being here, and also Charlie Knorr, who has provided some valuable state support. As Greg said, after he got through with that great list of what makes other cities famous, but Springfield is truly recognized as the birthplace of what became known as the iconic Mother Road. It was on April 30th, 1926, about 73, 74 years ago, at the Colonial Hotel, where officials first proposed US 66 as the name of the new Chicago to Los Angeles highway. Route 66 kind of meandered across the city from Kearney down Glenstone to St. Louis through Park Central Square, which was called the Square back then, to Olive and College Streets, and then headed west out what is now Chestnut Expressway. And today we celebrate a new milestone in the history of that route, the beginning of the birthplace of Route 66 Roadside Park. There are a number of groups that I want to thank for being involved. First of all, the Planning Department, you've already heard from Ralph on that. The Public Information Department, who puts events like this together but keeps the word out to our public about everything that's going on. Certainly a thank you to our Springfield Green County Parks Department for their tireless work on this project. This is the beginning of a major improvement for Springfield's west side that will benefit our residents for years to come. In addition to the groundbreaking we're doing today, this is also Public Works Week, and I want to give a special shout out to the people from the Public Works Department for the City of Springfield for all the work they do, not only on our streets, but also, you know, in our parks and in our green spaces and so forth. They are tremendous. And obviously, a project like this cannot be done by government alone. There are a number of partners out there. I see Rusty from UDA and the West Central Neighborhood Association. We have representatives from OTC, MSU, Drury here, Springfield Regional Arts Council, the Historical Sites Board. All of these folks are working together, collaborating to make this a reality. And in a couple of years, it's going to be a tremendous reality, and I can't wait to be back here to watch it open up. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, Mayor. While he has a full head of hair, Jeff Schrag is actually here wearing two hats. He is the owner and operator, obviously, of Mother's Brewing Company. He is also the current chairman of the board of the Springfield Area Chamber of Commerce. Please welcome Jeff Schrag.
Thanks to everyone for coming out this morning. I see many friends in the audience. The building that houses Mother's Brewing Company right over here at College and Grant, that is my 10th historic rehab that I've been a part of. Most of those have been in Springfield. One has been in Joplin. I certainly love the idea of taking old buildings and giving them new life. I love what we're able to do with the old bakery and turning it into a new brewery, a new craft brewery. You know, as I've worked on buildings in downtown Springfield, your perception of what is downtown, your perception of what is developable changes. I can remember looking at the building that now houses the Monarch Art Factory thinking it's just too far away. Well, now I have a building several blocks west of that, and it doesn't take large projects like Mother's to get a community area like College Street and West Central going. It just takes individual brave people who are willing to take a property and make it better than they found it, because that has a ripple effect. And then the next property gets improved, the next property gets improved. And every little bit helps. And something like this, where we're going in the kind of middle of the area for redevelopment, and the city is making strides to show that we care about this area, we care about the natural amenities, and then exposing some of the beautiful historic roots. Now, that's a wonderful thing about restoring historic buildings, is there always are historic roots, historic stories, a great way for folks to connect to the past and bring those connections to the future. So I thank you all for coming out today for this wonderful event, and thank you all for what you're doing to restore this important area of Springfield.
Thank you, Jeff, and thank you for your vision and your willingness to invest in downtown as well. It's those kinds of investments that make this possible. You've noticed there are 20 shovels. There are 20 hats. I'm going to list off 20 people that we would like to invite to come up to turn dirt. And here they are: Mayor Stevens, Councilman Jerry Compton, Councilman Craig Fischel, Tommy Pike, Glenda Pike, King Coltrane, Ralph Rognstad, Rusty Worley, Paula Brookshire, Tom Peters, John Price, Robert Killingsworth, Tracy Kimberlin, Jeff Schrag,
right?
Luke Rogers, Charlie Knorr, Clarence McElroy, Miles Park, Kirk Duranis. Please come to the front and grab a shovel and put on a hat.
Thank you.